Experiencing double vision, called diplopia, is actually a pretty common symptom with a lot of people that will experience it sometime in their life. And some of the causes might be from a serious issue. So in this video, I'm going to go over three different causes, more three different categories that can cause double vision with some bonuses at the end. Let's focus in. Now, double vision or diplopia can be described as when you're looking at a single image and it splits into two. So if I have one head, all of a sudden it splits into two heads, that's diplopia. And it can be side by side, straight up and down, diagonally, a mixture of all three. And sometimes people experience this periodically, sometimes maybe towards the end of the day, and some people live with it all of the time, full time. The number one category is a binocular vision disorder, meaning that your eyes are not teaming well together. Our eyes are supposed to point at whatever we're focusing at. That's what gives us a single image. If we have one eye that is kind of going rogue, meaning it's pointing at something else that you're not meaning to point at, then we may get double vision. And this can be classified as what's called a strabismus or an eye turn, meaning that your eye can turn in, that's considered an esotropia or an esophoria, can turn out, meaning an exotropia, or can point up or point down, hyper or hypotropia. Now, some people might be born with eye turns, and a lot of times the brain can adapt to this condition, meaning that they don't really have double vision because the brain learns to shut one of the eyes off, the one eye that's going rogue on them. And so it'll actually do what's called suppression. It will just black that eye out and just focus on the one eye. And so they still have a single image. Now, some people, the brain might not adapt to this, or some people acquire a tropia or an eye turn later in life, and so the brain hasn't adapted, and so these people tend to have double vision, and they can have double vision the whole day, all the time, full time. Now, some people might not have a full-time eye turn or tropia, but they might have a phoria, where an eye or both of their eyes have a natural posture to rest out or in. Now, I actually have an exophoria, so meaning when my eyes are really tired, or if you examine my eyes actually like to sit a little bit out, and my eye muscles have to work to keep the image nice and clear and single. Now, if I get really tired late during the day, then sometimes I can let my eyes just relax, and I'll get double vision. Now, some people will experience what's called decompensating vergence ranges, meaning that that natural posture might get worse with age, or the muscle's ability to control the eyes kind of goes down as they age. And so sometimes the double vision symptoms start becoming more prevalent and more often the older that they get. And it might be worse for those people when they go to look at something, maybe they look at their phone or reading a book, they can have convergence insufficiency, meaning their eyes don't want to point in as well. So their muscles will struggle harder and harder to try and make that image single. Now, a lot of times people with phorias or tropias will sometimes notice maybe later in the day they'll get double vision, and sometimes they can kind of blink and rub their eyes and focus it back and they'll be clear. Or sometimes they'll be driving maybe late at night or during the day and they've been staring for a long time, and all of a sudden they're starting to notice double vision. They can kind of refocus and snap back. And so sometimes it's just temporary and only happens for a few seconds, and then they can get it right back. Now, like I said, a lot of people are born with this type of condition or this type of eye posture, but some people can actually acquire it, or it can get worse as they age, or sometimes they can fall into a category called binocular vision dysfunction. And that's a more broad definition that I'll probably save for a complete separate video later, but that can involve strokes, neurological disorders, head traumas like concussions, that all can lead to these eye postures being misaligned and cause a binocular vision disorder. Now, luckily, there are treatments for this. In fact, there's a whole subcategory of optometry that is dedicated to vision therapy to help retrain the eye muscles of the eyes to kind of help with these symptoms. So vision therapy might be a good option for you. There are also prism that we can actually put in glasses where it reshifts the light going into your eyes. So it kind of takes the edge off the need for the muscles to stay focused. And so people that are experiencing double vision later in the day or maybe throughout the day. You can actually put prism in their glasses and help with those symptoms and pretty much alleviate those symptoms. And there are also eye surgeries that can help straighten muscles out at a younger or older age. The second category is a nerve palsy, where something goes wrong with the actual nerve that is innervating or triggering the muscles of the eyes. Now, this is a crazy statistic. There are 12 cranial nerves, and half of those nerves, six cranial nerves, actually do something, help control the muscles of the eye and eyelids. And three of those nerves control the eye muscles that move the eyes up and down, left and right. And this is one of those categories that can get more serious. So, like I say in many of my other videos, if you are all of a sudden experiencing double vision, you definitely need to go in and see your eye doctor. Get this checked. They may want to do additional testing or imaging to check on the nerves if this is what it's looking like is the cause. Now, when the nerve is affected, this affects the stimulation of the muscle that controls the eye movement. And a lot of times it can be just on one muscle of one eye. So sometimes when people look to the left, if that nerve is affected that is triggering that muscle to turn left, a lot of times people will see double vision when they look left. They might be perfectly fine looking straight ahead, but when they look left, if that muscle's not being stimulated like it should, then a lot of times people see more double vision in that field of gaze when they look left, or vice versa, when they look right, or if a nerve is affecting how the eye muscles look up, maybe one eye can't look up, but the other one does, and so they get double vision when they look in certain fields of gaze. A common cause for this can involve microvascular diseases like diabetes, high blood pressure, high cholesterol. This specific cause is common for people that are 50 and older, and a lot of times we'll need a blood panel to see what's going on, possibly imaging. But the good news is a lot of times this can resolve itself in 2 to 3 months. And this also can involve brain tumors where the tumor can actually press on the nerve, and sometimes people get double vision all of a sudden and the double vision will just stay there because that nerve is constantly being affected. And sometimes they'll say that the double vision is slowly getting worse as that tumor is growing. Again, this can be serious. I hate to throw out tumors, but a lot of times it can be serious and might need further testing or imaging to make sure or rule out stuff like this. Category number three is autoimmune disorders. So just add that to the long list of symptoms that can be caused by autoimmune issues. Probably one of the more common ones is thyroid eye disorder, where your immune system attacks your thyroid, but also can attack the back surface of your eyes and cause your eye muscles, the eye muscles behind the eyeball, to swell up. And because it swells up, it actually starts to push your eyeballs out forward, causing that bulgy eye appearance. Now, the bottom eye muscles are the ones that are usually more commonly affected, and so usually this affects the upward gaze of the eyes. And so a lot of times people will get double vision when they're looking up. There's maybe one eye that's more affected, so it kind of halts the eye from going all the way up where the other eye can go up a little bit farther and they'll see double vision. Now, this can be affected in all gazes. Thyroid eye disease can affect all the muscles, but the most common one is when you are looking up. Another autoimmune disorder that a lot of eye doctors will think of when we're talking about double vision is something called myasthenia gravis. This is where the autoimmune system can actually block the cells or block the neurotransmitter acetylcholine so that the muscles of the eyes and eyelids aren't getting the signal to work properly. And like I said, this can affect your eye muscles, which can cause double vision, but can also affect the eyelid, which can cause a ptosis or a droopy eyelid. And the symptoms of this are pretty specific, where people will say, hey, the morning I'm actually doing pretty good, their eyes are refreshed, their eyelids are refreshed, and then throughout the day that they'll notice that their eyelid starts to droop a little bit more, the double vision becomes more prevalent, and they just feel tired, and over the time of the day, it just keeps getting worse and worse. Another common one is multiple sclerosis. MS is an autoimmune condition where your immune system targets and attacks the myelin sheath that surrounds your nerves of your body. This myelin sheath is a fatty sheath that covers the nerve, and it helps the nerves trigger and travel faster. It helps the propagation of that nerve. Now, when you attack this myelin sheath and it disintegrates or becomes damaged, then you are affecting the actual nerve and how well that nerve functions. And this can affect motility in different parts of your body and can vary in different ways and in different people. Even the eyes, it can affect the eye muscles, it can affect the eyelids, it can actually affect the nerve, the optic nerve of the eye. In fact, one of the common things that a lot of doctors might experience is sometimes when a patient comes in with these symptoms and we see optic neuritis or maybe a swollen nerve, then sometimes we send people in for testing, and sometimes that's the first sign or first indication that they have MS. The treatment for double vision from an autoimmune disorder depends on the type of autoimmune condition that people have. A lot of times we can help with the symptoms using PRISM, making sure that they're getting the correct blood panel or imaging that is needed to correctly diagnose, but a lot of times the symptoms can be manageable. Now, this is probably a good spot to say that there are many different causes for double vision. I'm just scratching the surface here and only scratching the surface and explaining different disorders and causes. And if you want more details or a more detailed video describing a specific cause, then let me know in the comments. I'd be happy to make a specific video going more into detail about these causes. Now, a couple bonus categories. One can be the actual glasses that you're wearing can be inducing double vision. If you have high prescription, your glasses are crooked, your pupillary distance measurement, so the center of your glasses is off, you might be looking through different parts of the glasses, not the center of your glasses where you need to, and the glasses can do what's called induced PRISM, can induce a shift in the vision and cause double vision. So if you feel like your glasses are what's causing your double vision, make sure that you're going into your eye doctor, getting an updated prescription, and making sure that your glasses are made correctly and they're fit correctly to you. The other bonus category is monocular double vision, meaning if you have double vision in just one eye, if you cover one eye and you still see double vision or ghosting coming off images, then that can be from a whole host of other reasons and causes. And for that reason, I made a specific video for monocular double vision. Check it out right here. I'm Dr. Neil Guymon. Stay focused.